By the end of this video, you're going to learn something new. You're either going to be a Pandas nomad scripting away in a dark room and then be shown lights of the city of SQL, or you're going to be a SQL ninja that then learns the hidden art of how to manipulate databases with Pandas. Either way, stay until the end to make sure that you don't miss out on a single thing, and I'll catch you at the end of the video. Peace. You get it? It's Pandas versus SQL, part two. How's it going? If we haven't had the pleasure of meeting, my name is Andrew. You're on Data Leap, and this is where I talk to students, academics, and professionals who want to learn data science or something akin to it, because this channel is about having fun, making moves, and teaching you the second part of Pandas versus SQL. Now, if you haven't seen the first section, or if you haven't seen any Data Leap videos at all, welcome. You are very welcome here, and I hope you catch the first section, because this part of the SQL versus Pandas journey is going to be a little more advanced, so I hope you're ready. Today's guide is, as last time, based on a Medium article on Tor data science that is written by Dario Radishish. Dario wrote the article SQL versus Pandas, How to Choose in 2020, part one, and now part two. And what we're going to cover in this video is the more advanced methods in Pandas versus SQL. If you're a programmer that works in Python and Pandas, this is your guide to learn SQL. And if you only know SQL, this is your chance to learn some Pandas and be able to script and be able to flex your Python and Pandas knowledge. If you know both, hey, stick around, and me and Panda, this is going to teach you. Welcome to this or data. Delete! The delete statement is something that we didn't get to cover in Pandas versus SQL 1 because you weren't ready for it. But now that you are ready for it, the delete statement in SQL is very simple. You just tell SQL what you are trying to delete. And for example, what we're deleting here is right below my face or right above my face. One of those two. Let's put it above me. This allows you to delete one row or multiple rows, but this is not the same thing that we do in Pandas. In Pandas, we select the parts of the table that we want and discard the rest. That is slightly different and nuanced understanding of it, but the syntax is as follows, right above. Now, both of these are very simple statements, so I have to be inclined to give Pandas an A for A. That's pretty straightforward. And SQL an A for A. That's easy to read.
Joins!
This is a good time to talk about joins, something secret and special in SQL, but also exists in Pandas as well. The join in SQL allows you to merge two different tables together. There are left joins, right joins, full outer joins, and inner joins. Now, what are the differences between these joins, you might ask? Well, let's do a quick crash course. Let's start with the inner join, which is what joins are by default. Now, an inner join takes a column that you're trying to find in common between the first table and the second table. Let's call them the left table and the right table. Now, if one of the column values exists in the first table but not the second table, then we don't include that final row, and vice versa. If something happens in the second table but doesn't happen in the first table, we don't include that row either. That's why it's an inner join. They have to agree. So now let's go for an example. Let's say that you're trying to put two tables together. One includes all the Renaissance painters and their favorite colors, and two includes all the Ninja Turtles and their favorite pizza flavors. Flavors? Toppings? Toppings. So if you wanted an inner join between these two tables, the final output is going to be a row with each of the four Ninja Turtles, which coincidentally is also four Renaissance painters. And what you're gonna have is the information of their favorite colors from the painters and the favorite pizza toppings from the turtles, and nothing else. See? Easy peasy. Now, how does that differ from a left join and a right join? Well, a left join and a right join are considered outer joins because now you are considering this part of the Venn diagram or this part of the Venn diagram. There's two circles involved. You see, when we want to consider a left join on the example that we had before, we would take all of the Renaissance painters, even if they don't have a Ninja Turtle counterpart, and keep them in the final output. But for the names that do have a Ninja Turtle counterpart, we would also append their pizza flavors. Toppings, oh my god. But the difference is that all of the other Renaissance painters would still exist in the output, but they wouldn't have a pizza topping that they like because they didn't exist in the right table. There you go. Conversely, a right join is the same, but with the right table. Keep everything that exists in the right table, and if they exist in both tables, include the values from the left table. Otherwise, just have a null value. Finally, a full outer join combines the left and the right, so the entire Venn diagram, the center part, plus the two circles that represent the left table and the right table. That is a full outer join. For pandas, it's slightly different. We can take the pd.merge method and merge two different tables, or data frames in our case, together. And we can even indicate what kind of join, like the left, right, outer, and inner. And we can take in what we want to join on, the column, just like in SQL. Both of these are very straightforward, but pandas does seem to be a little cleaner, and SQL seems to be a little bit easier to read. But SQL is the OG, the original big daddy of putting two tables together. So let's give SQL an A for originality and pandas A for sleekness. So let's go back to the Renaissance painters and the Ninja Turtles example. Well, you probably realize that they're not exactly the same people. One refers to the actual painters and the other refers to crime-fighting Ninja Turtles. So if you wanted them to be reflected as separate entities, as different rows in your output, you wouldn't want to join them, you would want to union them. That would put two different tables together as an output of one select statement from multiple select statements. Now, union in SQL by default removes duplicate values, but you can have union all, which does not remove duplicate values and exists in pandas as the dot concat method. If you did want to remove duplicate rows, you can first use the pandas.concat and then use pandas.dropduplicates. As you can see, it only takes one step in pandas to do the union, and it's pretty clean, but that only is a union all. Of course, concat refers to union all. If you wanted to do a proper union and remove duplicates, it does take pandas two steps. So a two-stepper in pandas means we don't have any precious time to waste. That's a B if you wanted to do a union. Of course, if you wanted to do a union all, then SQL gets the B because, hey, pandas already has you covered with concat.
Group by!
Group by is an interesting method that allows you to work in conjunction with aggregation methods in SQL and pandas. Sometimes you want to find the min, max, count, sum, average of a specific data set, but you also want to see it for a group or a combination of groups. For example, you want to see the count of Renaissance painters' favorite colors, but you want to see it grouped by which country they originally reside from. Well, that becomes a lot easier when you use the group by method, because then you'll see that Italy has this many colors, and you'll see X, Y, and Z have this many colors, blah, 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 blah. As always in SQL, it is very, very easy to read, and it is clear what you are trying to do. But in pandas, it is a lot sleeker, and it may be a little harder to read, but here it is. It is also called group by. Now, in terms of confusing you, pandas does that very, very well, because you have to use the dot ag method after group by, and then you have to pass in a dictionary of what kind of aggregations you actually want to see. That could be pretty confusing if you aren't familiar with it. Of course, people who are already native to pandas may differ. Of course, I want to speak from an objective point of view, and I think that pandas means that you're going to have to learn a couple more steps in order to be able to use group by effectively. So that gets a B for better luck, a little more, less confusing. And SQL, as always, gets an A for beautiful, simple, lovely cover girl SQL. So, was that pretty straightforward, and did you learn a whole lickety-split lot of stuff? If you have a favorite color or pizza flavor, topping! If you have a favorite one of those things I mentioned, please leave it in the comment below and tell me, did you like that this or data? Which of this or data did you like? Tell me if you're team pandas, or tell me if you're tribe SQL. Tell me if you're team pandas or tribe SQL in the comments below. Hit that like button, make sure to subscribe, and smash that bell button, because I have so much more material just like this to help you become a six-figure data scientist in 6 months. My name was Andrew, it's still Andrew, and I'll see you guys next time. How about some comments? If you're up for it, I'm up for it too. Peace. Rhea was the inaugural data success story on the channel. She commented, "I had a great time discussing and filming this with Andrew from Data Leap. He answered a lot of my questions and helped me decide my next steps into learning DS. Thank you, Andrew." Rhea, it was a pleasure, and I hope to see you again on the show soon to hear more about where your story's going. Mirio said, "This was funny, thanks." Thank you, Mirio. Luke says, "Nice vid, what laptop do you use? Learning data science right now with an outdated laptop. Should I get a powerful desktop or just upgrade my laptop? Thanks." Hey Luke, great question. Can you effectively run a Jupyter notebook? Then you should be fine for most learning cases unless you're running complex models. Check out my Python installation video and see if you can run the code in that guide. I'm using a newish MacBook, but you can use PC, Linux, anything that gets you there. Virtual machines, containers might be your friend. I'll make a video about that soon. Kenji says, "Your life is so much more interesting than mine is." Ken, that can't be true. But let's have a competition and find out. Andrew Zhao says, "Starting work at 11 a.m. is the dream." Well, let's live it together, Andrew. AP Jerome says, "Nice tips for beginners." Thanks for the comment. Means a lot, AP. Dr. J.L. Burgess says, "Day 9 of 66 days of data." He says, "Sadly, I have had to take a 2-day break. I did 2 13-hour shifts at the hospital this weekend with no downtime. This is why more doctors don't learn how to code. FYI, I'm taking a career break and that's why I have time. Recharging my dead brain, I watch Andrew from Data Leap talk with Rhea on his new YouTube video. Although I'm not looking for a career change, it's great to hear what other beginners are doing, particularly if their field of study relates to medicine and healthcare. Thank you for that shout out on Discord, and I'm really glad that more doctors are starting to code. If you have a very particular life experience and you have somehow found a couple of my videos relatable, successful, or something that you would want to see, I really appreciate you putting that in the comments. Have a good one. Peace.
Talking about.
It's Panda versus SQL.